Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. On this video, I'm going to tell you about what is NP9 in full detail, the nonyl phenol ethoxylate. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time, make sure that you subscribe, smash that like button, and also consider dropping us a comment below. So what is it that I'm going to show you on this video? I'm going to tell you about composition of NP9, its properties and uses, okay? And there are about two experiments that I'm going to make throughout the video. So make sure that you remain tuned till the end so that you can learn this. At the first place, what is the composition of NP9? You need to know that NP9 is an organic compound composed of phenol bearing a 9-carbon tail, okay? So what are the properties of NP9? Okay, there are actually many. We're going to state few. Property number one, as you can see, I do have NP9 with me. It's a colorless liquid, okay? That is property number one. That's it. Property number two, it's non-ionic in water. It simply means that it does not produce or give out any charge in water. That's it. Then property number three, you need to know that NP9 can form in water. NP9 alone can form in water. These are one of the things that I'm going to show you from the experiment, okay? Then property number four, NP9, this very same NP9 that you see, it's an emulsifier, okay? Means that, let's say here I do have oil that I'm going to mix with water, then I'll show you how NP9 will actually take away the separation, okay? It will make water and oil mixed. If you never knew before that NP9 can also be used as an emulsifier, you're going to see that on this video as part of the experiment, okay guys? Here we go with the experiment, okay? So what is it that I'm going to show you on the experiment? The first experiment, I'll show you how NP9 can form in water, okay? NP9 alone can form in water. That's something that you need to know. Then the second experiment, I'll show you the emulsifying property of NP9, okay? What is it that we're going to do? That will be the second experiment. I'm going to mix oil and water. You're going to clearly see the separation, okay? Then I'll bring NP9. Then you'll see how the separation will actually go away. So it's also an emulsifying agent. It can be used as an emulsifier. So all along, if you did not know that NP9 can be used as an emulsifier, it's what I'm going to show you as experiment on this video on a closed camera. Here we go. Here we go with the experiment, okay? Before going further on, I'll first pour NP9. This is my NP9 that I'm going to pour into this container so that some of us can see the appearance, thickening properties and the viscosity, okay? Here we go. This is NP9, okay, here we go. You see how NP9 is? For some of us who never went across this, this is NP9. It's just an ingredient that does a lot, an ingredient with many properties, okay? Here it is. That's it. Then I'm going to pour it back into this container to give you a better idea. This is NP9. That's our NP9. You see how it is? It's colorless, thick. It's an ingredient that matters a lot just because of its properties. Okay, I was saying that I'm going to show you the forming properties of NP9. What is it that I'm going to do? Let's pour some NP9 here. We mix it with water. NP9 alone can form in water. This is NP9. Okay, which I'm going to mix with some water. Let me put some more. Okay, that's it. Okay, I've poured some NP9, then I'm going to put some water into it. It's already forming, I'll show you. here it is. You see how it's forming. Let me show you how it's even forming now. You see the form? Okay. That's it. And it's not a weak form or a small form. It's really a form, as you can see. That's it. Okay, it's an ingredient that can do a lot. That's it. Now, let us go to the second experiment where I'm going to show you the emulsifying property of NP9, okay? As I said earlier on, you also need to know that NP9 can be used as an emulsifier. Here we go. Here we go, guys, with experiment 2. On this experiment 2, I'm going to show you that NP9 can act as an emulsifier. Okay, it's what I'm going to show you. I'm first going to mix water and oil. Okay, you clearly see the separation. Then when I put NP9, you'll see what will actually happen. The separation will go away. Okay, it simply means that NP9 is an emulsifier. Okay, it can be used as an emulsifying agent. That's it. Here we go. Let's pour water into our container. This is our common water. Okay, then oil. Okay, this is something we all know. I'll show you the separation. Let's put some more oil. There's no specific ratio here. I'm just showing you the properties. Yeah, it is. This is clearly visible. You can see the separation. You can see the separation, okay? Even here it is. You can see the separation. That's it. Here we go with NP9, our emulsifier. You see what will happen? There we go. You see how the separation is going away without any effort. We're obtaining an homogeneous mixture. Okay. That's it. Obtaining an homogeneous mixture, a bit milky because of oil, but there's no separation. That's the main thing to show on this experiment. There's no separation at all. We're obtaining an homogeneous mixture. Let me mix it properly, then I'll show you. Okay, look at what NP9 can do. It can actually do a lot. From profile and on a close camera, okay? There's no separation here. That's it. Now let us get to the uses of NP9. Here we go. So what are the uses of NP9? There are actually many, okay? We're going to state few. At the first place, you need to know that NP9 can be used as detergent, okay? That's it. It can be used as wetting agent. It can be used as thickening agent, okay? It can also be used as an emulsifier. As I just said from the beginning, it's a chemical or an ingredient that can do a lot. That's it. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure that you subscribe to the channel. As I always say that there is a lot to learn from here, trust me. And there are still many more videos to come. Make sure that you like our videos, share them, and also suggest the channel to people you know with the interest of learning. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure that you subscribe and see you on the next video.